Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video we are going to see operation of P channel and N channel JFET. So in my previous videos I have discussed about the construction of N channel JFET and P channel JFET. So if you have not seen the video, please check the playlist guys, you can find the same video. Okay, so if you are not subscribed the channel, please guys subscribe the channel, and if you found this video useful a little bit at least, so then you can press the hit like button also. Okay, so if you want you can do that please. So now coming to this topic, that is operation of P channel JFET and N channel JFET as well, so both are same. So here I have taken the example of N channel JFET, where N type of material is taken and P type of highly doped impurities are penetrated in this. So this is the formed P channel, and a voltage is applied between drain and source. So electrons will be produced or start moving towards the drain, because this is positively charged battery terminal. So electrons will be attracted to the positive terminal here. So they will start moving towards drain. So the we know that if the electrons are moving in this direction, then the current will be in the opposite direction to electrons. So the drain current will be flowing in the opposite direction of electrons movement. So the electrons moving in upward direction, the drain current is in downward direction. Okay, so that's all how the current is generated. All right, so this is the gate terminals, they are shorted and given to the gate. So in the open condition, that is when no voltage is applied between gate terminals, then this, that is the junction formed between this and this, that is P and N junction. So this is the junction which is formed between them. P region is there, N region is there, so there is a junction between them. So this is reverse biased. Okay, so due to that no current is flowing, or only a small amount of current is flowing in the reverse direction, so that is practically taken as zero. So if the voltage applied for gate is zero, then it is assumed that the reverse current is zero. Okay, all right, so what happens if we apply some gate voltage? So that's the interesting question here. So here the gate voltage is directly connected to the drain and source voltage. So what will happen? The depletion region width will increase. So that is the due to the drain voltage, the current will be flowing in this direction. So there will be voltage drop in this region, because the N type of material is having resistance. So when there is a voltage drop, then obviously this P region got extended to this side. Okay, so that's why because this is highly doped and this is lightly doped, the depletion region will more penetrate into the N type rather than P type here. So as you can see, if you increase the gate to source voltage, that in between two gate terminals, that is this one and this one, so then the depletion region will again increase. Okay, so it is increasing in the N type of region, leaving only a small area. So at the end, when you increase the gate voltage to that level where the saturation of the saturation occurs, then this will be completely blocked. Okay, so there is no flow of current in the JFET, and that mode is said to be cutoff mode for the JFET. So at that time no current flows through this channel, because they are completely blocked by the depletion region. So it should be noted that if this is a drain and this is a source, then there will be more depletion at the drain as compared to the source. That will be something like this. So there will be no low gap in case of drain as compared to the source. For source there will be large gap here, but for drain it is very small gap will be there, because the voltage drop will be higher at this end, because these outer external voltages. So this is how, by increasing or decreasing the voltage between the gate terminals, we can control the amount of current which is flowing through the JFET. So that's why it is called as voltage control device, because the voltage applied between these two terminals of the gate determines the amount of current which can flow, or it determines basically the working of this JFET. So that's why BJT is called as current control device, whereas JFET is called as voltage control device. So all right, that's all about how a JFET works, and what are the different situations, how the gate and gate voltage can be varied to get the varying amount of current. So I hope you found the video useful. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.